And welcome back, guys. We're going to be playing some more Planetcrafter. So today we're going to be exploring the shipwrecks and things like that. Regarding the base itself, it's now automated by the drone system, which took me an hour to set up. Let me just kind of make a good example so we know how we got mutation in here. Well, I had to go over here, click on whatever the hell I want in the box, have the drone put it in there, and do this for each box. And guess what? I get to redo it again after getting it set up. How, why? Well, I got the tier 2 storage module from the trader shop, which I didn't even know what the hell it was. I just kind of clicked it and fucked around and found out. And, well, it offers a shit ton more storage, and it's probably better to upgrade each one of these to one of those than to currently have just one of these. Because look at how much space this is, how much space this is. And then look at the comparison to this. Holy shit. Now, I'm more surprised how much iron I have. So please remember, the drones are currently taking the supplies from the ore extractors. This is the aluminum mine. And it's bringing it over here, depositing it into its individual boxes. And then they're coming over here to the sulfur ore extractor, bringing it over here, then they're going to the osmium cave where the osmium ore miner is, and they're going to the iridium cave where it has the iridium miner. You kind of get the idea. The drones are over the damn place right now. But if we go over here, I don't know what this drone's doing. I don't know why it's doing in the middle of nowhere. As far as I know of, I don't have a base over there. So I'm more kind of like, huh? Like it says there's something there. This has got to be underground or something, because oh wait a minute, maybe that's the iridium cave because there's the passageway, so maybe that's what it is. I don't know. It's kind of find it strange at this point, but yeah, we're slowly going around deconstructing those little bases I had all over the place for jump in there real quick, get some O2, get out. We're going to be going around the map deconstructing those because we don't need them anymore. What's the point of having them sitting there wasting, space? And, it gets laggy when you get too much crap at your base, so it's probably better to just get rid of anything that you're not currently using. So, let's say I have like one module out here, I should just get rid of it, So that's the plan here today. We're gonna be launching a map rocket, basically. That's what we're gonna be doing here in a second. So, yay, I get to redo my storage system with super storages. Damn it. Pretty much. Yeah, not much going on. So, let's just kind of look here. So, the next thing we have to look forward to is exoskeleton at 86. And the aquarium. We really need this unlocked, this way I can make my super storages really fast. But yeah, we're gonna be unlocking that portal eventually. And we're getting close to endgame, at least I think we are. I'll consider this being endgame. Ooh, we should definitely check out trying to make that at some point. I'll say basically endgame for me is when you have everything unlocked and there's nothing more to unlock. That's just how I see endgame. Anyways, make sure to like button, make sure to subscribe button. Let's get into playing some more Planet Crafter.
Yeah.
Alrighty, that looks like a good place to stop. Make sure to like button, make sure to subscribe button. I'll see you guys next video.